Hello, and welcome to this week's special edition of Sunday Super Church Segment! I'm your host, Pastor Tony, the host of Studio CK. So what makes this so special? Well, two things. First, Pastor Tony, our field consultant, is starting a brand new series called Jesus Centered, and I'm super stoked about this. It's going to be good. The other, well, it hits a little close to home. Here at Studio CK, we've been hearing some rumblings that me, the host, our field consultant, Pastor Tony, and our worship leader, Pastor Tony, are the same person. I mean, come on. That is just silly, right? Well, so I figured I would just bring them in here real quick and show you. So, welcome everybody, Pastor Tony, the worship leader.
Saw, dudes.
What's with the guitar?
I don't know. I'm a worship leader.
And our field consultant, Pastor Tony.
Well, hello, Central Kids, and how are you today?
Dude, what's with the voice?
I don't know. He got to have a guitar. Yeah, nice song. I wanted something. Why do you have a picture of yourself?
What's wrong with my picture? It's a great picture.
I don't know. It's just weird.
Okay. Well, as you can see, we're three different people. So I'm done with you guys now. You can leave.
Hey, can I use your studio later?
Fine. Yes. At least just this time. Anyway, let's kick it off with Pastor Tony, the worship leader, who's going to lead us with an awesome song, and then we're going to jump right into Pastor Tony, the field consultant. But if he's in the studio again 2 weeks in a row, does that make him a studio consultant?
I don't know.
Here we go!
Hey guys, Pastor Tony here, worship leader for Studio CK, and I'm pumped to worship with you today. So, you know the drill, get off your seat, get on the floor, get your hands up, get ready to sing. This song is called Forever Reign. Let's pray. Jesus, we love you, and we know that you will reign forever. You are the Lord of everything, you are the Lord of lords and the King of kings. We praise you and worship you right now in Jesus' name, amen. And oh, I'm running to your arms, I'm running to your arms. The riches of your love will always be enough. Nothing compares to your embrace. Light of the world, forever reign. You are more, you are more, you are more than my words will ever say. You are Lord, you are Lord. All creation will proclaim. You are here, in your presence I'm made whole. You are God, of all else I'm letting go. And oh, I'm running to your arms, I'm running to your arms. The riches of your love will always be enough. Nothing compares to your embrace. Light of the world, forever reign. I'm running to your arms, I'm running to your arms. The riches of your love will always be enough. Nothing compares the scene. No other name. Jesus, Jesus. My heart will sing. No other name. Jesus, Jesus. My heart will sing. No other name. Jesus, Jesus. My heart will sing. No other name. Jesus, Jesus. I'm running to your arms, running to your arms. The riches of your love will always be enough. Nothing compares to your embrace. Light of the world, forever reign. Nothing compares to your embrace. Light of the world. Forever rain.
Love you guys. Hey, 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 Pastor Tony here, field consultant for Studio CK. Or am I the studio consultant now? 2 weeks to make you a studio consultant? I don't know. I want to thank Pastor Tony, the host of Studio CK, for allowing us to use his studio. I know how very particular he is with his stuff. He doesn't like when people touch his stuff. I'm not touching your picture. Oh, I bumped it. I'm sorry. Sorry. After we did kind of sneak in here last week, huh, Steve? Yeah. So anyway, thanks, Pastor Tony, for allowing us to use your studio. And thank you for mentioning our brand new series called Jesus Centered. I'm excited about this series because it's really going to get us to dive in and focus on Jesus being the center of our lives. And why is that great? Well, because Jesus should always be the center of our lives, right? So, the title of my message today is called Chosen. So, how do we choose or how have we been chosen? Well, the whole entire Jesus-centered series is going to take place in the book of Ephesians. So, hurry up, go grab your Bible. Get your Bible, hurry up, run, go. I'll give you 10 seconds. 10 seconds, okay, I'm glad you got your Bible. Whether it's on your phone or your paper Bible, whatever it is, I want you to follow along with me. Find verse 4. That's after 3 and before 5. Okay? So we're going to read verse 4 together. It says, "For he chose us in him before the creation of the world to be holy and blameless in his sight and love." So before we go any further, let's pray together. Father, in Jesus' name, thank you for your word. Thank you that your word brings forth change in our hearts. God, it's good for teaching and correction. Father, I pray that you would use me and use this time so that we would all have changed hearts and make you more the center of our lives. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, so let's break down this verse. How did he choose us in him? Okay, so it says he chose us in him. This means he picked you before you chose to give your heart to him. He already picked you. So continuing on, before the creation of the world, what does that mean? See, God already knew the present. He knew the right now. He knew everything that's going on. And he knew the end before the beginning ever even started. Man, that's hard to wrap your mind around. Well, but that's true. He already knew before anything ever even happened. The next part, it says, to be holy. What does holy mean? Holy means to be set apart for a certain purpose or to have a specific calling. You have a specific purpose. You have a specific calling. The last part it says, and blameless. That means without doing something wrong. And then it says in love, but that's the next part of the next verse. But he did this all because he loves you. He loves us. So now that I know that I need to make Jesus the center of my life, well, where does my choice come in, right? So this whole thing's about chosen. Well, I'm glad you asked. It's a really great question. See, I think sometimes we make Jesus the savior of our lives. You know, when we go up front and you pray and you say, "Jesus, forgive me of all my sins," and you change a little bit and you stop doing some of the things that you did. You know, you claim I'm a Christian now, but we forget a very important part. We forget to make Jesus our Lord. See, we're called to make him Savior and Lord. When we ask Jesus to forgive us, that's making him our Savior. But when we ask him to be the Lord of our lives, that's completely surrendering everything. That's him being the center. Because if we are trying to be the center, or if we're just giving him a little bit, so it's like this chair that I'm sitting on. We say, Jesus, this is your chair. I want you to sit on. I want you to be the Lord. But can you scooch over, because I want to do things the way I want to do them. But that's not right. We need to make Jesus our Lord. When we make Jesus our Lord, we give him that chair to sit in. And we say, Jesus, I want you to sit in that chair. I want you to be the Lord of my life. Okay? Does that make sense? You getting it? Because when you tell him to scooch over, that's you trying to gain control, and then he doesn't become the Lord of your life. Then he's not in the center. He's not in the center. He's shoved off to the side. So let's put him in the center. All right? So here's what we're going to do. We're going to pray. All right? When we pray, would you say this with me? Okay? Jesus, I'm sorry. I'm sorry that I don't make you the absolute center of my life. Would you come now and be the center of my life? Would you be the Lord of my life? I give you control. You can have it all. If you made that prayer today, if you made that choice today to make Jesus your Lord, I want to see it in your comments. And maybe have your mom type it in, or your dad type it in, or whoever type it in, or you type it in. Say, Pastor Tony, I made that choice today to make Jesus not only the Savior of my life, but the Lord of my life. And I'm proud of you, because it's important. Jesus is the center of it all. Well, I love you guys, and I can't wait to see you next time. Bye for now. And we're back. We're back. Okay. Hey, Pastor Tony here, host of Studio CK. I know it's looking a little different. Usually I'm seated down, but I was just, man, Pastor Tony, our worship leader, he does a really good job. So I was just up here worshiping, and I figured I wasn't going to make the guys reset the studio and all that stuff. So I just want to say we're out of time for this week. We all love you very much, and we'll see you next week. Bye! Woo!